Morning folks, and as you can see I'm up at Loch Awe, Kilchurn Castle in the background. I've already taken some photographs this morning, but almost had a disaster. I've got the drone with me, and when I went to connect the phone up, that was in Chinese or Japanese, and I couldn't actually get the drone up when the best light was here, so managed to fiddle about with the phone, and it's come back to English, and I got the app up, but I was a bit worried about flying it over the water, and just in case it went back to Chinese and I lost signal, but I don't know. But anyway, the footage I've taken has been mainly from the side of the loch. In the third of the moments of reflection, I was thinking this morning about the photographs that I take that are actually unique. Now, when I say they're unique, I don't mean they're absolutely brilliant photographs. They're probably not that. But they're unique in that they're the only photographs that have been taken on this day of the week, this time of the morning, in this location, because these photographs will never be taken again. And when I was thinking about the uniqueness of photography, and we all have unique photographs, I was thinking about how unique we are as human beings. Now, it gets back to whether you believe in evolution or whether you believe in creationism. Now, if you've been watching any of my videos, you'll know that I just don't believe in evolution at all. I'm a creationist, and I believe that God created the heavens and the earth. And so that's probably a subject for another time, but I just want to touch on it briefly when we look at ourselves as being unique. Now, if you believe in evolution, then what you're believing in is that in the beginning there was nothing. Nothing took nothing and created us as human beings. If you're a creationist, you believe that in the beginning there was God. God took nothing and created us as we are today. Now, if you believe in evolution, then you believe that we're here by chance, and that we're no more important than our pet dog or any of the other animals, the fish in this loch. We're no more important than them. If you go down that road, that we're here by chance. But the Bible tells us that God created us, and that he created us in his image, male and female. That's another topic, probably for another day, but he created us male and female. And the Bible also tells us that he knit us together in our mother's womb, before our parents even saw us. God was working on us, just bringing us together, forming us as human beings. And because he hand-created us, he loves us, and he says that we're unique, we're one-offs. Now, if you think about it, nobody else who has ever lived has got the same fingerprints as I've got, or the same fingerprints that you've got. And nobody that comes after us will have the same fingerprints either. We're unique in that respect. We're also unique in that nobody else in the world has our DNA. We're the only people in the world that have our DNA. No matter how many billions of people have lived before us, or how many billions of people live after us, nobody else will either have our fingerprints or our DNA. That's how unique we are, and that's because God created us. We're not here by accident. We're here because he planned us, he moulded us together, and he has a plan for us. One of the things that I carry with me when I'm out taking photographs, landscape photographs, is my Kindle, which has a copy of the Bible in it. And I want you to listen to what it says. There's a Psalm 139, just a few verses. Verse 14 says, "I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful, I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. How precious to me are your thoughts, God. How vast is the sum of them. Were I to count them, they would outnumber the grains of sand. When I awake, I am still with you." Now, quite clearly God says that we are his creation, he made us. And I don't know what your background is, whether you've grown up with parents who have told you you're worthless, whether you've got a partner that says you're worthless, you're no good, you can't do anything right. That's not the way God looks at you. I say God made you, he loves you, and he says you're precious. He says you're a masterpiece, there's only one of you, and he just loves you with a passion. Now, the Bible tells us when sin came into the world, that separates us from God, and that's something that God doesn't want. And the depth of his love is shown by the fact that he gave us his son, the Lord Jesus Christ, to die on a cross for our sins. Now, if we put our faith and trust in him, then the Bible tells us we'll spend eternity with our Father God in heaven, and that's what he wants for us. He's our Father. He'll never tell you you're worthless because you're so precious to him. So I'm going to show some videos now. I've just asked you to think about these things. Don't just take what people say about evolution as being fact. How can nothing create nothing? I mean, if you just, it doesn't take a brain surgeon to work that one out. It just wouldn't happen. So give it some thought and think about the things I've been saying about God and God's creation. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll put some videos on now. Okay, thanks.
I was blind, now I'm seeing in color. I was dead, now I'm living forever. I had failed, but you were my redeemer. I've been blessed beyond all measure. I was lost, now I'm found by the Father. I've been changed from a ruin to treasure. I've been given a hope and a future. I've been blessed beyond all measure. I am counting every blessing, counting every blessing, letting go and trusting when I cannot see. To me. Oh, 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 oh. good to me. For your goodness, I will ever praise you. Now, oh, you are good to me in the hurting. Oh, you are good to me. I'll sing it loud. Oh, you are good to me even in the dark. Oh, you are good to me. Lift your voices. Oh, time. Oh.